I have to shout out Greg Charles from Caroline's, because he was the one who let me know that you started working the door at Caroline's right by where Sirius is. And I know there's a lot of people facing a lot of hardship right now that are aspiring actors because they can't do these face-to-face auditions. You know, they can't really excel in their career the way they used to. So what would you say to people right now? Because you worked a lot of low-level jobs to get to where you are. What kind of advice or encouragement can you give to those actors out there who are just kind of stuck right now with everything going on?
Man, well, first of all, Greg Charles, I haven't heard that name in 30 years. You know, so shout out to Caroline's Comedy Club. Look, you know, I'll answer that question by telling you a story. You know what I mean? I left the UK in sort of like early 90s, and I had like saved up a bit of money. I was working as an actor. I saved up a bit of money, and I came to New York. My wife at the time, I was young, I was 25 years old. And I didn't work as an actor for about 3 to 4 years straight up. I didn't have, my savings got depleted real quick. And I found myself in a situation where it was either I give up on my dreams or I go home. Give up on my dreams and just fly back to England, right? And it, you know, the hard truth is that, you know, it's a hard pill to swallow when you know you got the chops. You know you can do it. You're right there. You're knocking on the door, but you can't get in. And then you have to go and do something else that is off your skill set, that just to make some ends meet. That little cusp right there is the difference between those who make it and those who don't. And that's the bottom line. I would not have the career I have if I packed up my stuff and went back to England. I wouldn't. And so I just got stuck in, man. I worked a few jobs, man. And, you know, D.L. Hughley would tell you, you know what I mean? Dave Chappelle would tell you, all those guys, you know, I was working the door and all those guys were doing the circuit. I used to hustle. I had to hustle. There was no getting about it. It was either I hustle or I go home. And so I worked Caroline's, you know, I told people I used to dish out the weed bags here and there. You know what I mean? I used to DJ. I had all sorts of sort of gigs that would just get me a little bit of money so that I could keep my dreams alive. It's demoralizing, but at the same time, it was character building for me. Mm. Like in that time period, I became the actor I was, you know, going to be because I was practicing. I had my eyes on the prize. Even though I was doing these other jobs, I was practicing. So I would say to anyone that's out there that's listening right now and you're like, damn, I don't know what to do. I might have to go and get another job. I might have to do something else. I don't really want to do that. Do it. Get your money up, get your confidence back, and get your focus right. Because what happens is when you're sitting still just thinking, I'm going to give up, you just, you know, you're not sharp. You're not as sharp. You're not focused. You're not hungry. When you go out there and do a job that is off what you want to do, it helps you just be focused. Be good at something. It's like if you can't get into the gym, right? And, you know, you need to pick up something heavy in your house to just work out. Bottom line. Otherwise, you lose your muscle. So it's that kind of mentality. And I really feel that people, you know, we're so used to the idea of, you know, giving up, you know, because everything's so fast now. We want everything so quickly. And, you know, so when you don't get it quickly, you lose your attention span. You just, you know, give up. Don't do that. You know what I mean? Like, stay at it. It's a long game. Anyone that's good that's ever done it, Sway's been doing this for a long time, right, Sway? And you know that even when you're on the top, you still have to work hard and you still have to focus and you still have to do other things that are outside your skill set. I do. Mm-hmm. That's why I got 19 jobs right now, but I still do because it keeps me sharp, keeps me focused.